Good afternoon. Today we have already discussed about the introduction of the compiler. Now the second chapter is lexical analysis. So that is the phase one of the compiler. We have already discussed compiler, interpreter, their properties, advantages, disadvantages, failures of the compiler, compiler construction tools, grouping of the compiler, grouping of the phase of the compiler, types of the compiler, bootstrapping of the compiler, edges of the compiler. Now, the next topic is lexical analysis. What is the means of lexical analysis? We have the character stream of data. Lexical analyzer, it convert the input stream, input character stream into the tokens. Text and reference, same. In this lecture, we will discuss about the role, block diagram, functions of the lexical analyzer, means of the tokens, pattern, legends, regular expressions, DFA, NDFA, construction of NDFA from the regular expression, two approach for design of lexical analyzer, NFA to DFA conversion, and direct method for conversion of regular expression to finite automata. See the role of lexical analyzer. Lexical analyzer, it takes the input string and convert the input string into the tokens. So that is the parser. Parser means syntax analyzer. It will take the tokens after generating from the lexical analyzer, then it makes the semantic syntax tree. Function of the lexical analyzer. The main task is to read the input character and produce as output a sequence of token that the parser use for the syntax analysis. It produces a string of tokens. It eliminates blank and comments. It generates symbol table which stores information about identifier, constant, encountered in the inputs. It keeps track of line numbers. It reports the error encountered while generating the tokens. Tokens. What is the means of tokens? A token is an input of characters categorized according to the rules of a symbol. It describes the class or category of the input strings. Identifier, keyword, constant are called as token. For example, now see if int big int a int int a int b. If A is greater than B, if A is greater than B, return A, else return. This is the function for getting the largest number between these two numbers A and B. We have two numbers A and B. We want to find the largest number. We know that this is the simple function. Now this is the input string. The input string is converted into the tokens. See how here legend and First is IND. First is IND. We know that what is the means of this IND? IND is the keyword. Then bid. What is bid? Bid is identifier. Then this parenthesis IND again A. In this way, it converts the collector string into the tokens. Pattern. It is a description of the form of that the legends of the tokens may take. Legend is a sequence of character in the source program that matches the pattern with the tokens. Next is the specification of the tokens. See, string means it is a collection of finite number of alphabets and letters. So that is the string. The length of the string is denoted by the length of the string is denoted by if we have the string S, then the length of the string is denoted by this. Empty string can be denoted by empty string is denoted by empty string, and the empty set of string is denoted by empty set of string. Is denoted by. So in this way we can denote this. Next is the operation on the language. Operation on the language. If L1 and L2 are the two strings, then what is the means of union L1? L1 union L. It is the set of string in L1 and set of string and string in L2. This is the, what is the means? Set of string in L1 and string in L2. So this is the means of this union. Then L1 dot L2 means set of string in L1 followed by set of string in L2. Set of string in L1 followed by set of string in L2. Cleans closure. The cleans closure. What is the means of this cleans closure? The cleans closure means L closure means this is the union I equal to 0 to infinity L1. So this is the cleans closure. Cleans closure denote 0 or more occurrence of L. 0 or more occurrence of L. Next is the positive closure. Positive closure means union I equal to 1 to this L of I. So it means, what is the means of this? L L plus or positive closure denotes one or more concatenation of L. So these are the means of tokens. Next is the regular expressions. We have already discussed the regular expressions in the CS358 theory of computation. What is the means of the regular expressions? Regular expressions means representation of any set of string in algebraic fashions. For example, A closure B. This is the regular expression. Regular expressions are mathematical symbolism which describe a set of string of specific language. It provides convenient and useful notation for the representation of tokens. Regular expressions. MD is also a regular expression which denotes a set containing MP strings. Just discuss. If R1 and R2 are the regular expression, then R equal to R1 plus R2 is also a regular expression which represents the union operation. And if R1 and R2 are the regular expression, then R equal to R1 and R1 dot R2 is also a regular expression. It represents concatenation. If R1 is a regular expression, then R equal to R1 closure is also a regular expression which represents the union theorem. So next is the block schematic of the lexical analogy. Here input buffer, all the tokens are stored in the input buffer. Here, the lexical analyzer stores the inputs. Lexical analyzer stores the input in the buffer, in a buffer. So that is called input buffer. It builds the regular expression. It builds the regular expression for representing tokens. For representing tokens from. It builds the regular expression for corresponding tokens which from regular expression to a finite automaton. Here the input buffer where all the tokens are stored. Here from the input expression they have the regular expression. From the regular expression we can build the finite automata. From this finite automata use the pattern matching algorithm and the corresponding tokens are generated. So here when the lexical match with the pattern generated by the finite automata, then the specific tokens get recognized. So next is the finite automata. Finite automata is one of the mathematical model that consists the number of states and the edges. It is a mathematical model which contains the five tuples n equal to q sigma delta q0 and f, where q is a finite set of states, sigma is the input set of finite set of input alphabets, delta is the transition functions. Q0 is the starting state where in which state the machine starts, and F is the final state after processing of a string. What is the final state? So F is the final state. So every finite state machine, it contains these five tuples. So there are two types of finite automata. One is the deterministic finite automata and another is the non-deterministic finite automata. NDFA and DFA, these two contain all these two contains pi doubles, but the difference is only in the transition function. Here in the transition function, delta map from q into sigma to q, and here it maps q into sigma to 2 to the power q. Here, which is the power set of q? The set of all subset of q. Here, in this case, there is at most one transition from each state on any input. Now see, I want to explain this with an example. What is the DFA and what is the NFA? First see the transition graph. A transition graph is a finite directed graph, level graph, in which each vertex or node represents a state, and the directed edge indicate the transition of a state, and the edge are labeled with input and output. So this is the definition of the transition system. See the example of the transition system. See one question. Design a finite automata which accept even number of zeros and even number of ones. See the transition graph q0 q1 q2 q3. This is 0 0 1 1. This is 0. This is 1. This is 1. This is 0. Or 0, 0, 0, 1. Here, this is the initial state q0. The machine starts from the state q0. We want to design a finite automata which accept only the even numbers of 0 and even numbers of 1. Now suppose the string is 0 0. Machine starts with the initial state q0. If the input is 0, then the machine changes state q1. Again in q1, if again we have 0, again the input is 0, then the machine reaches to the q0. It means that is the final state. Here we process the string which contains even number of 0. Or if we have the even number of 1, then it will also accept. Like this, now suppose if we have 0, 1, 1, 0, then the machine start from q0, initial state is q0, input symbol is 0, then the machine change q0 to 0, so that is the q1, then again now the 1, q2, then 1, q0, q1, then this is q0. In all the cases, the machine start from the state q0, after processing of the even number of 0 and 1, then the machine will process the string. If we have the odd number, then the machine will not reach to the final state. So this is the DFA. For every input, there is only a single gate transition. So it is, so this is called transition diagram. This is called transition diagram. Now, if we want to prepare the transition table, then we can prepare in this way. State and sigma, this is the 0 and 1. These are the four states, Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Q0, 0, so that is the Q1. Q0, 1, so that is the Q3. Q1, if 0, then Q0. If 1, then Q2. For Q2, 0, then Q3. For 1, then Q1. And for Q3, 0. For Q2, and for 1, so that is the Q2. Here, this is the initial state, and this is the final state, so it is called transition diagram. This is called transition table. This is the transition diagram, this is the transition table. Then, now we want to design the machine. Now we want to write the finite automata. So what is the finite automata? M equal to Q. Q means all set of states. Here we have four states. So all Q0, Q1. Sigma input alphabet, so that is 0 1. Data, then initial state is Q0 and the final state is also. So this is the DFA. So this is the DFA. Now see what is the NFA. Now see what is the means of NFA. Q0, 0, Q1, that is 1, then 2. See here, in this case, this is the transition diagram. Machine starts from the initial state Q0. If the input alphabet is 0, for the input alphabets, the machine can move to state Q1 or it may to Q0. Same. So here, for the same input, there are two transitions. So here it is not deterministic. So it is called non-deterministic finite automata. This is the transition diagram for NFA. Next, logical analyzer generator. To design the logical analyzer, first design the pattern of the regular expression of for the tuples, and from these patterns it is easy to design the NFA. We have already discussed, if we want to convert the regular expression into a finite automata, first see we have the tuples, and from these patterns of the regular expression, design the pattern for the regular expression from the tokens. So see how can, so there are two approach One is the pattern matching using the LFA and another is using BFA with lexical analysis. So building of the lexical analyzer, input string, convert into the patterns, then from the patterns, prepare regular expressions. From the regular expression, we can convert to the NFA, and if we have the NFA, then we can convert to DFA, and then lexical analyzer generate. It generates the tokens. So here, see, construction of NFA from the regular expression. So if we have NFA, here we have the requirement, we have these requirements. Here we have the pattern. From the patterns we have the regular expression. Now we want to convert this regular expression to NFA. So what is the method? How can we convert this regular expression into the NFA? So see, first construction of NFA from the regular expression. Construction of NFA from the regular expression. See, for R equal to M, its equivalent regular expression, its equivalent, the NFA is QF, this is the. Then for R equal to A, Q0 A QF, then for R equal to R1 plus R, then Q0 QF. Here this is the N of R1, this is the N of R1. This is the R equal to R1 plus R2. For R equal to R1 dot R2, here this is the Q0 starting state, N of R1, N of R2, QF, this is the final. Then for R equal to R1 plus, here this is the Q0, this N of R1, this is the MD, this is the this QF final state, and this is. We have this regular expression. We have the equivalent energy of this regulation using the null. See, now we want to construct A closure. A closure means this. एक यूजर। फर्स्ट वी प्रिपेयर दिस टू जीरो दिस एमटी दिस इज क्यू वन ए क्यू टू एमटी दिस इज क्यू एफ दिस इज द एक दिस इज द एक दिस इज द एक क्लोजर सी ए क्लोजर बी सो व्हाट इज बी दिस इज क्यू थ्री दिस इज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट A closure B, then we can connect like this. Now this is the A closure B. This is the empty. And from this empty we can reconstruct this. So this is the here you can say this is the Q4 and this is the Q4. This is the MG. So in this way we can prepare the NFA from the regular excitation. Next is NFA to DFA converter. Next is NFA to DFA converter. NFA to DFA converter. NFA to DFA converter. See how can we construct the DFA from the NFA. See the example. Find a deterministic acceptor equivalent to M equal to Q0, Q1, Q2, AB, delta, Q0, and this is. Where delta is given by Q0, Q0, Q1, this is Q2, this is Q1, Q0, Q1, this is Q2, see, this is the question. Here we have this machine, we want to construct the DFA, deterministic. We have this machine, we know which type of machine is this. This is the NFA. For the state, here initial state is Q0, what is the final state? Q2, this is the final state. So, for the state Q0, input symbol is 0, then we have the two transitions, Q0 and Q2. So we can say this is the NFA. Now we want to convert this NFA to DFA. So what is the procedure? How can we convert this NFA to DFA? So make a transition table for So this is the NFA. Now transmission cable for DFA. Make the transmission cable for DFA. How can make the transmission cable for DFA? Here state 01, this is the 20. For the state 20, what is the next state? 2021 and for the state 22, what is the next state? 5 and 20. Then for the next 20, for the 20 21, what is the transition? Now we can 20 21 C0, that is equal to delta 200 Q1. So here what is 200? So that is 200 Q1 union 210. So that is no, 210, so that is 20. So that is equal to 20. Like this, 20, Q1, 1, so that is 201, Q1, this is 201, Q01, it means Q2, Q11, so that is equal to Q1. So now we can write Q0, Q1, Q1. Here Q1, Q2 is the next state. So here Q1. For this Q1, Q2, again we can calculate Q1, Q2, 0, so that is equal to Q1, 0, Q2, 0. So this is Q1, 0, Q0, Q1, 0, so that is Q0, Q2, 0, 5. So that is equal to Q1, Q2, 1. So this is Q1, 1, Q2, 1. This is Q1, 1, Q1, 1. So that is Q1. Q2, 1. So that is Q0. In this way, we can convert any NFA to DFA. So this is the transition table for. If we have a transition table for DFA, then we can prepare the transition diagram. So this is the DFA. In this way, we can convert any NFA to DFA. Now we can prepare the transition diagram. We have the transition table. So now we have converted this transition table of NFA to DFA. Next is this part is over NFA to DFA conversion. Now the direct method for conversion of regular acceleration time to final acceleration. We know that we have already converted. If we have the regular acceleration, then we can construct the NFA with the null mode. This. Design a transition diagram. These are the three steps for the given regular expression using the NFA with the null moves. Then convert this NFA with null move to without NFA null without MD. Then convert the obtained NFA to the DFA. Now see the example. Construct a DFA with reduced state equivalent to regular expression 10 plus 0 plus 1 1 0 plus 1. See, Q0 is the initial state. This is the QF is the final state. 10 plus 0 plus 1 1 0 closure 1. Then in the next step, this is the starting state. In the next step, now break this, and this is the QF. This is the 10, this is the 0 plus 1 1, 0 closure. Then what is the next step? This is the Q0, this is 1, this is Q1, this is the 0, this is the QF, this is 0 plus 1 1. This is 0 closure and this is 1. Then now you can make the Q0, this is 1, this is Q1, this is 0, this is QF, then this is 0, this is Q3. Then this is 1, this is Q2, 1, and this is 2. This is the initial state, this is the final state. So this is the transition diagram for this regular expression. So now I want to ask, what is this? This is NFA or DFA? This is NFA or DFA? This is the NFA. For the state Q0, if the input is 1, then there are two transitions. Machine can move to Q1 or it will move to Q2. So this is the NFA. Now prepare the table for NFA. State 01, this is 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. For the 20, 0, 23, for 1, 21, 22, for 21, 2F, and for the 1, 5. Then for 22, 0, 5, this is 23. Then for 23, this is 23. For 1, this is 2F, then 5. This is NF. Convert this NF to TF. The same method. We know how can we convert any NFA to TFA. Just we have discussed in the last method. Then for 20, so what is this is 20, here this is 23, this is 20, 212, this is 21. Next state is 23. So what is 23? 23 and this 12. Then next state is 21, 22. So what is for 21, 22? 21, 0. So 21, 0. So that is 2F. 22, 0. So that is 5. Then this is 23. 21, 5, 22, 23. So this is 23. So next state is 2F. So that is 5. So this is the transition table for DFA. In this way, if we have the regular expression, then we can convert to NFA. Then we know how can we convert the NFA to DFA. Then so we can convert to DFA. So this is the DFA. We can also minimize this DFA. We know the method. We have already discussed this method in the CS 358 theory of computation. So apply this techniques and we can reduce this DFA. So this is the method, direct method for conversion any regular expression into the finite domain. Thanks. Then so these are the references.